Good morning. It's Saturday. Beautiful day out. And I want to talk about working on Saturday. In the industrial age, before the industrial age, people worked as farmers. They worked all day, every day, for the whole year, planting season, whatever. If you go to a foreign country and you ask a person about a foreign country that isn't in the Western world, you get back in the woods, they have no concept of what vacation is and what did you do for your weekend. What is it? What did you do for the weekend? Did you go to the beach? That's not a concept to people who live outside the Western world because they're struggling to survive. So when we went into the industrial age, that's when the 40-hour work week came in. And so just consider ourselves lucky that we can even work 40 hours a week and survive. Remember, in a corporation or a business, they'll feed you, but they won't let you get fat. The only way to get ahead is to be doing your own thing, running your own business. And you gotta be very careful about the type of business you choose, because you wanna be careful. Are you buying a business where you just become self-employed? Think about being a plumber or being an electrician. As long as you're swinging the hammer, you're self-employed, and you have the risk of losing the ability to work. From the neck down, you're worth $10 an hour. From the neck up, you're worth whatever you want to be. But we also have to work on the weekends and work during all crazy hours, because if you want to be successful, there's someone else out there that's doing it too. And those are choices you have to make. You know, people may say, you know, you need to take it easy. Well, last year I went to Israel for 2 weeks. I've been to different countries and visiting, so I don't work all the time. I'd make them working vacations. I can't sit on a beach for a week and relax and do nothing. I make my vacations or trips. I send them around. This is something my wife and I did a few years back. We decided to center all of our trips and travels around our, what are we gonna learn? How can we better ourselves? So we would go to, say, a seminar or something. And then if it was in Florida, I'm thinking of one in particular, we went to a seminar in Florida at Marco Island, which is on the west side of Florida. Beautiful. Spent 4 days around there, met a lot of really great people. And we spent a couple of days afterwards enjoying the beach. And then we came home. And that was an awesome trip / vacation. But if you're going to be successful in anything you do, you're going to have to put in the hours. And if you're trading time for money, then you're only worth whatever the maximum amount of hours there are in a week. So if you're going to be doing these things, being successful, you got to put in the time and effort. You know, I see people that they want everything. They'll tell you that they want everything and that their family is first and all this kind of stuff. But yeah, really when it comes down to it, they're addicted to the TV. They use their children as an excuse. You should use your family and children as a reason to succeed, not as an excuse to lose. So I just want to share that with you guys, because I work every day. And if you're going to be running any sort of a business, you're going to be working every day. It's on your mind every day. And if that's not for you, well, just remember there's always a job out there. And if you don't have the money to be in a business, then you need to have a job to make the money, but always have something going on the side that you can work to get out of the job. Because remember, company won't pay you. They'll let you eat, but they won't let you get fat.